Last night at D23, there was a Disney Entertainment Showcase. This featured content from Marvel, Lucasfilm, Pixar, Disney Animation Studios, and of course, Disney themselves. One of the last presentations at the panel was, in fact, Tron Ares. Now, we're going to start off this topic by talking about the logo that we have for Tron Ares, and honestly, I don't mind it too much. I know a lot of people don't like it because it's a lot different from the Tron Legacy logo, and Tron 1982 because the first two movies have had such similar logo designs. But personally, I'm really enjoying the vibes of this logo. To be honest, at first I wasn't sure, but I'm really liking it now. Yes, that's right. Nine Inch Nails is composing for Tron Ares. So I guess my prediction of Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross composing for Tron Ares is semi-correct because while I didn't guess Nine Inch Nails, they are still members of Nine Inch Nails. And since I made that prediction video, I actually recently heard the Challenger score, which was made by Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross, and it just increases my hype for what they're going to do with Tron Ares. Now let's get some more info about the characters in the film.
I play Julian Dillinger, and for those of you who know anything about Tron, you know that the name Dillinger doesn't always mean great things for those on the grid.
So straight off the bat, one thing very interesting about this is Evan Peters is not replacing Cillian Murphy as Ed Dillinger Jr. like many originally thought. Instead, he is a family member of the Dillinger family, Julian Dillinger. Currently, it has not been said what his relation to the Dillinger family is, but I'm hoping that maybe he's Ed Dillinger Jr.'s brother.
I play a human character, I can say that, named Eve Kim, and she's a brilliant programmer whose greatest work provides a path for Ares to come into our world. Oh my God, I've already said too much. That's enough.
I play Ares Master Control, the Dillinger Grid, a program who's looking for a way to make the real world his own permanently.
Based on what Jared Leto just said right there, it seems like the Master Control program from Tron 1982 is almost merging with a program because he said Ares is a program, but he is the Master Control of the Dillinger Grid. And I mean, come on, it's not too far-fetched to have the Master Control program in a Dillinger Grid. I mean, it already happened in Tron 1982, right? During the panel, there was also a trailer for Tron Ares that was released, but not to the public, only attendees at D23. And while I won't be showing any footage or any photos of the trailer, I will be explaining what happens. This is to avoid any copyright strikes or DMCA. And I do see why it wasn't officially released yet, because even Jared Leto says it's a bit rough still. So if you want to wait until the high quality version is officially out, I highly suggest you do so.
You know, our dream was to bring the magic of light cycles, recognizers, and disc battles from the grid to the real world. And today, we reveal that dream becoming a reality. Although everything is still a bit rough, we do have something special to share with you.
So we start off with seeing Julian Dillinger talking about AI and the world today, and about how people are asking when we will be going to virtual worlds, but instead, they will be coming to us. We later see Ares on the Dillinger Systems grid, similar to what we saw on the teaser photo, and he travels to the real world with the assumed intention of making the real world his own. We see him talking to Greta Lee's character Eve Kim at a location that reminds me a lot of Sam's house from Tron Legacy. I believe it was also shown in some set photos, and I assume that this is when Ares is transported into the real world. We see many other programs also in the real world now, likely from the same grid as Ares. These programs look a lot like Black Guards from Tron Legacy, but new versions of them, and we also see a new Recognizer that looks a lot like the Recognizer from Tron Uprising. It's also quite reminiscent of the Super Recognizer. While Eve Kim is running from the Recognizer, we see two light streams right in front of her from two new vehicles that look like drones of some sort. I'm gonna call them light drones. I also think that this could be a new type of missile from the Recognizer in the background. So to be honest, I'm not even sure if they're drones. We also see a loading dock that looks very similar to the one in Tron Legacy, except the whole color scheme is red, so I believe this is in the Dillinger grid, and I believe that there's also a solar sailor there. Later on, we see Eve Kim in a light suit, but the one confusing thing is, she has a circular disc. All of the other programs seen so far have that triangular disc that we saw Ares have in the teaser photo. So I'm wondering, maybe she's not on the Dillinger grid. It's either that, or maybe users just have circular discs on the Dillinger grid. Now, this is one of the most interesting parts for me. We get to see a brand new vehicle on the grid, and it looks like some type of speeder bike, but I see a lot of people calling it a light skimmer. Now, for those that don't know, the light skimmer was used in concept art for Tron Ascension back before Disney pulled the plug on it in 2015. And based on what Joseph Kosinski has said in the past, who is originally attached to that project, he said a lot of inspiration has been taken from the original Tron Ascension script. In fact, the original story for Tron Ascension is that programs are coming to the real world, which is the synopsis of Tron Ares. Shortly after, we see a city, which is very reminiscent of the architecture from Tron Legacy. One thing I noticed though, a lot of the circuitry there is blue instead of red, so maybe this is in another grid. One of the last parts is a dream come true. We have two light cycles driving around the real world, and then we see both light cycles on the freeway with a cop car chasing them, and one of the light cycles enables its light ribbon, which splits the cop car in half. Lastly, we see Ares waking up in what I believe is another grid, and then he sees what seems to be Kevin Flynn walking out of a 1982 Tron tank. However, it's purple, along with his circuitry being purple, and he has his classic 1982 Tron circuitry with that kind of triangular logo, so it's really nice to see that return. Honestly, after 14 years of waiting, I'm starting to think this might have been worth the wait. And there's a lot more Easter eggs in the trailer from what I've heard, but I'm going to be waiting until the trailer is officially uploaded by Disney so I can do a full analysis video on it for you guys. Anyways, that's going to end it off for me. That's a lot of news to take in. I'll see you guys later. End of line.